Hello, teacher friends. Super glad that you are here with us today for a heartfelt episode of the teacher vlog. My name is Monica Genta, and I have invited one of my good friends to the episode today. His name is Juan. You probably know him from Instagram as Teaching Third with Mr. G, and I have invited him onto this episode to talk about something that he is super passionate about: read alouds in the classroom. Now, if you are not an elementary teacher or not a literature teacher, don't worry, this episode is still for you because he makes some incredible points about how we have to make whatever we are teaching be the rock stars of our class. You are going to love this. Now, at the end of the episode, I thought it would be fun if I do a little read aloud with you for a book that I want you to know more about. But for right now, let's get rolling with this episode. All right, friends, we are here with Juan right now. He is an amazing educator from Texas, and he's got a passion for books and a passion for read-alouds. And honestly, I'm really excited to hear about this because as a middle school science teacher, it is not something that I know a lot about, but I know it's something that's really important for young readers. So welcome. We're so glad to have you here.
Yeah, I'm excited to be here. Thank you.
Yes, I know when we initially started talking about having you on here, you said basically books saved your life. And I think that that is a really cool, just passionate statement. So tell us more about kind of how this all happened, like where read alouds kind of fit into this whole puzzle in education.
Yeah, absolutely. So I think looking back at my life, as a kid, I've always loved books. I've always considered myself a reader.
Mm-hmm.
But that was like a self-taught or more like of an innate feeling that I had. Like, it's just what I love. Innately, mm-hmm. I love reading. I love books. It's who I was.
Yeah.
And so I was somebody that knew teaching from high school. Like, when I was in high school, I knew that I wanted to be an educator.
Mm-hmm.
And I loved teaching for this idea of that I could create lesson plans and I could hang out with kids all day and I could help them be their best selves. And that's why I loved education. And so every job that I had in college, I worked with kids. My whole career, I've been working towards being a teacher. And then when I finally became one, it was all the things that I loved. And then it was harder than I ever imagined.
Right? Yeah.
You don't realize all everything that it encompasses. And so when I first started to teach, and I had to figure out how to teach, right? Like, I had all these great ideas, but when you're finally given your standards and your content, then you have to make something of it.
Yeah.
And I think literacy instruction is one of those things where it is so complex and there's no definite answer on how to do it well. When I was in the classroom and I had to teach reading, it was scary.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's no infinite answer as far as with math. It's very finite. This is how you do this.
Yep. Yeah.
And with reading, it's I always call it a big bowl of spaghetti.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Like, there's so many different ways and there's so many processes that are going for a student to grow as a reader.
Mm-hmm.
And so for a while, box curriculum is good when you're first starting out. And what happens when you want more?
Mm-hmm.
Right? And you want to engage readers. And you're feeling more confident as an educator and you want to do more with reading. And that's when I realized, for me, books were my answer.
Yeah.
If I could share books with students, if I could read to them, if I could figure out what each kid liked and I could engage them with literacy, I was going to do so much more for them as just a human being.
Mm-hmm.
And so then I started doing my own research. And that's why I'm so glad social media has given us an opportunity as educators to go find our people,
yes.
Our people who had kind of have the same thought process or going through the same things that we're going through. And then mm-hmm. we can support each other and give each other resources.
Yes.
And then through that, that's where I found, these things that I were feeling where I knew that books were important or read alouds are important. There was research on that. And I had no idea about that
mm-hmm.
because my district didn't know either. I think, and not to put down my district, but I think everyone's trying to do their best, and sometimes you don't know your best practices until you go out there and you do the research.
Exactly. Yeah.
And so when I did that, it changed me. It changed my drive to be in the classroom. It made me more excited to be to be in the classroom, because before, of course, I loved the creativity of creating lesson plans. Mm-hmm. And so then it changed to like, how can I get more books in the classroom? How can I read more to my students? How can I get them passionate about reading? And then I would say that it changed my life, because finding this newfound passion to bring literacy, like not just teaching, but also literacy to students, it just changed me. And then it's what I think about. It's like, well, it's what I do now. And it makes me really excited. And I'm so thankful that I have something that gives me that passion, that excitement.
Awesome. I love that. I think that's like really, really cool, meaningful background on on why these are so important to you and for our readers. So as a teacher who's like, I want that, like I want students in my classroom to feel the same way about books, that they saved their life as students, what would you say, what tips do you have about getting those read-alouds into the classroom?
Yes. So the very first thing, one thing that helped me from the very beginning, this is a tip that I received from someone, and I don't know who gave it to me, but it helped me in a really big way, is that in my planning, I have a read-aloud block built into my planning time.
Yes.
So in some weeks I'm lucky that I can do it 5 days a week, and then some weeks I can only fit it in like 3 days a week. Mm-hmm. So not being hard on yourself and saying like, I have to do it every single day, but looking at your lesson plans, and as you are planning your day out, finding those, whether it's a, and you plan it, like maybe it's a really great book that you're just sharing because it's really cute and it's fun, or you just want to do a book talk and you want to introduce it and you just have 5 minutes to do it, or maybe you have a good 15-minute chunk where you can go through a whole chapter or go through a whole picture book. Mm-hmm. And you put it into your lesson plan and you say, like, on Monday at the end of class, it is read aloud time.
Yes.
And so when it's built in, then you can't let it slide. You can't forget about it.
And I think that's a really good point, because in education, it always feels like there's, oh, I got to get this in and I got to get this in. And we always look at it and think like, how are we going to do that? Like there's not enough time in the day. So it's a simple strategy, but so meaningful. Block it in there. And then it goes with the flow. It's there.
Exactly.
So it's blocked. Let's do this. Brilliant.
Right.
Very
totally.
Cool.
And then another thing that I was, and you know, I'm so lucky that I get to talk to educators and I have a platform to do it, and I get to go speak with teachers hard on things like that. And one thing that I always say is we must make like books the rock stars, right? Like I think when we're dealing with kids now, like this whole new era of social media and the internet, it's so easy. Like kids, I think naturally become fans of things, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they will become fans of things that we talk about.
Yes.
And so I think when we talk about books, when we talk about literacy, I would say school reading is not a school thing, it's a life thing.
Yeah, I love that.
That's what we need to be doing.
Mm-hmm.
And so when I talk about books, when I display them, when I talk about my life as shopping for books, like I make it exciting.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's not a show or anything, where like I'm not putting on like a it's not fake.
Yeah.
When I say
like
I'm putting on a show.
Mm-hmm.
I'm excited about the books that I'm sharing. So like if there's a book that we're reading, like this is a chapter book, like if you follow me on Instagram, The Wild Robot for the past couple of years has been a book that my students have loved. Teachers have loved sharing it with students. And so like I'll just display it like in the morning. Like that will be like my like on my whiteboard, the books there on the whatever slide I have in the morning to welcome them.
Yes.
Or if I'm introducing a new picture book, I put it up on the board. And so it's this idea that if we bring books into the front and it's not about just school or like you have to read, but it's an exciting thing, that's how we get them to buy into it. So I always just say like make the books the rock stars. Make the kids excited about them. Because when you, Donald Miller, who's an amazing author, always says that kids will love what we praise.
Yes.
And if you're in the classroom, you know that. Like as a teacher, if you walk in and you grab something, you're like, I love this. This is so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Instantly, they're drawn in, right? And they want to know more.
Yeah. I think that's so, so important, because so many times you hear that like schools aren't a business, right? And I totally agree. But at the same time, I feel like teachers are salespeople. We are selling products to students all day long.
Yeah.
And if we can sell the love for our content and make whatever we're teaching the rock star of the moment, that's so good. Because it's also that visual that you're talking about. You have a picture of it. You have it available for kids to see that, like, this is what Miss Genta is reading. This is what do people call you Mr. G?
Yeah, they call
me
Mr. G.
So this is what Miss G is reading. This is what Mr. G is reading. Like, that's so important, because, you know, you use the term, like, make books the rock stars.
it's such a cool thing to be in a profession where kids feel like teachers are celebrities. Like, we are the rock stars and we are, quote, selling something. So let's sell them something awesome that is going to change their life.
Yeah, and that's so true. Back to what you're saying about how, like, it's not a business, but even like me, like, I thought before education, I wanted to go into, like, sales or marketing.
Mm-hmm.
But I much am more happy selling real content and real ideas that makes people better. And that, too, like, we have to be, even before social media, like, even me as a kid, like, I thought my teachers were cool. Like,
yeah.
You can think back to your teachers and think, like, oh, that was such a great teacher. I love being around them.
Mm-hmm.
And even, like, if you're watching and you're listening to this, you know, in your classroom, you have those students who are instantly, like, googly-eyed over you and listening to every word and things like that. Not everyone, right? Like, some you have to work at.
Right.
But that's kind of like a natural vibe that happens in the classroom. So let's use it to our advantage to really get them excited about the things that we want them to be. Great.
Absolutely. Oh, Juan, you are amazing. It's so nice to have a variety of teachers on this teacher vlog. And I love that, like, I get really excited when we have male educators on here, because speaking of, like, you know, selling your passion, I didn't have my first male teacher until I was in seventh grade. And I just think it's so great because kids are connecting with teachers for different reasons.
Yes.
And I just think it's so important for our students to see that, like, this profession is for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And anyone can be passionate about it. So thank you for helping your third grade students and students in your school see that, like, you can be passionate about what you teach, and you can be a guy who's a teacher, and you can love what you do and really put it on the platform that it deserves to be on.
Right on. Thank you for that. Thank you.
Wasn't that episode a great one? Okay. Yeah, I'm sorry. Juan probably does not appreciate that joke, but I just couldn't help it. There were so many jokes that were going through my head about that. Like, oh man, he is a Juan passionate teacher, right? These are terrible. I'm gonna stop with the Juan jokes, but truly, I think he is such a feeler. I love his heart for education, and I thought he brought up some really great tips during that episode. Now, I promised you a read aloud, and I actually want to read from my newest book, Crushing It for Kids. Let me do a read aloud of actually what this book is about. It says, every single person who walks into a school deserves to love that experience. Whether you are a student, a teacher, a parent, or education leader, walking into a school each morning should be an exciting adventure. And I know it can be when we crush it for kids. Because a school is just a building until we transform it from average to awesome. Friends, that's what Crushing It for Kids is all about, and I would be so pumped to have you in the newest edition of the Crushing It for Kids April 21 day challenge. Guys, back in February, I did this course with over 150 educators from across the United States, and it was an insane amount of fun. I'm getting ready to relaunch this course, and it begins April 1st. Registration is open, but it is closing very soon, and there are still spots open for you. You can click the link below to find out more about this, but I'm telling you, if you want to end the year on a good note with a little reading and a whole lot of fun, this 21-day teacher challenge is for you. Also, in the episode notes, you can connect with Juan on Instagram. You can feel his love on that platform. But guys, I hope you felt the love during this episode, and I want you to continue to feel the love as you walk into your classroom this week. Remember one really important thing, friends. Hey, you got this.